friends, hope you all are doing great. Tassin here. Today I'm here to talk about how to use Google Sheets. As we all know, when we want to do a data entry job or else actually we want to do some edit an option in our document, we need to know how to work with Google Sheets. So we are all familiar with Excel, but let us actually find new and interesting features in Google Sheets at the same time. I will tell you from the basic to advanced level what are the features of Google Slides. So let's get into our session. So let's first get into Google Chrome. There are two ways of methods how we can get into Google Sheets. So either we can just type here sheet.new. So sheet.new, it will directly take us to the sheets where we want. See, this is the spreadsheet. So this is also one way. The other method what we can do is just get into the other tab. Actually, I want to get into our Gmail account. And once we get into our Gmail account, what we can do is so once we get into our Google account, just click the square shape dotted lines, Google Apps. And here you can see my drive. So just click on your drive. So once you click on your drive, here you can see a plus symbol on the right side. So just click new here and so once you click new here, you can see folder, file upload, folder upload. Here, Google Sheets. So just click on Google Sheets. So this is the one. So all I'm going to do is I'll show you how to work with it. So this is our sheet. So first and foremost thing I want to tell you is let us give a name for our sheet. So what I have to do is all we have to do is just we have to here you can see untitled spreadsheet. Just click on it. Here you can give your own name. Any name you can give for your sheet. For example, I'm going to just save this as demo. Okay, so once this is done, so just press enter. This is automatically it will get saved in your drive. Here you can see save to drive. Here you can see that it will automatically get loaded in your Google Drive account. So you need not to worry about saving this sheet every time. You need not to press Control S. So I'm going to talk about exciting and very interesting features about all this from basic to advanced level. So try to just watch this video till the end so that you can have a clear idea what is Excel sheet. So let's start. So here I can see actually the lower section. So let me zoom this first so that you can see. I'll keep it for 200. Yes, so this is perfectly all right. So all I'm going to do is here you can see add sheets. So what I'm going to do, if you want more sheets in the same, if you want more sheets, you can add on plus. So I'm going to do just, see, sheet 1, sheet 2. If you want more, I can press sheet 3. So like the same way, you can have more sheets. And you want to just get into which sheet. For example, I am in sheet number 1, sheet number 3, and I want to get into sheet number 1. So I can jump very easily by just clicking this horizontal lines actually, which I have all sheets has been filed up. So it is easy for me if I'm working on 20 sheets. If I want to jump from one sheet to the other sheet, it is very easy here. And when I click on sheets, for example, if I right click here, you can see move right. If I click on move right, it will move this side and sheet number 2 will come this side. And if I right click this, so here is the option, if we right click move to right or move to left and hide this sheet. For example, this sheet 1, if you don't want to use it or you want to hide for some time, you can hide it at the same time. So let me show you how to hide it. For example, I have written here something called ABC in the sheet number 1. So and then what I'm going to do is just I'm going to right click on the sheet number 1 and I'm going to click hide sheet. So just wait and watch. So here you can see the sheet is hidden. So here you can't see the sheet number one. If you want again that sheet number one back in your folder, so all you have to do is here you can see all sheets, just click on it, and here you have sheet one. So once you click, that hidden file will again come. So here you can see ABC. So you can also hide your sheets if you don't want to use it, or you want to make some changes, you want to use it later, you can hide sheets. And all about product sheets. So for example, you don't want anyone to make changes in your sheet other than you. You can give a permission to protect. So what is this all about? I'll tell you. So what I'm going to do is, now I have written here 6, I have written here 7. So this is in sheet number 1. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to right click this and I'm going to say that protect sheet. So now nobody can change that 6, 7 and ABC except me. So protected sheets and ranges. So enter the description why I'm protecting. Just we can say I'm an admin so that I don't want anybody to change this actually. So it is asking me whole sheet or you want to just select a range. A range in the sense from one cell to the other cell. I'll explain you what is mean by cell. It is asking me the portion, a range which you want to protect. I will tell I want to just click on the whole sheet to be protected. So here I'm going to click on set permission. So here it will ask me restrict who can edit this range. It is asking me. So what I'm going to click is actually I'm going to click only you. So it means only I can edit the sheet, others can't edit the sheet. So this changes has got saved. What does mean by others editing our sheets? See, in Google Slides and Google Docs, we have amazing features. Even 10 and more people, number of people together in team can simultaneously work with this. So I will show you how it really works and all that in this video. So watch till the end. If you like this, kindly click on like button and also subscribe my channel. So let's get into the point. So next is, so you can protect and you can rename your sheet. Like for example, for the sheet number one, I'm going to type as ABC. So this is my ABC. So that also you can do. So here I have protected the sheet. So it shows that actually a lock. So I cannot, except me, no one can change the data in this sheet. So it shows a lock button. So what I mean to say is if anybody open this and try to delete and actually try to type some other number, they can't do it, but I only can do it. So that also I'll show you with how to actually, if I connect with other account, actually, if I try to edit it, I can't edit it. So next sheet, next the point comes to, let's see, right click. And if you want to rename, you can rename. And you want to have a duplicate copy of the sheet to the same data what you have typed in this sheet. You can also have a duplicate copy. I'm going to click on duplicate. So here you can see a copy of duplicate sheet 3 also has got produced here. And then the point comes to delete. I want to delete sheet number. I don't want to delete. I don't want to delete this copy. So that all I have to do is if I have to delete. So I'll right click. And just a minute, I'll right click here and I will just delete this sheet. So it will ask me, do you want to delete this sheet? So I'm going to just click delete. So this is all about the down part of the session, how to have more number of sheets and also the more number, how to delete, how to protect and how to hide. This is all about this. And here in when the point comes to slides, sorry, when the point comes to sheet, here you can see A, B, C. So this is called as columns and 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is called as rows. So the intersection of this rows and column is called cells. I mean to say this is each and every rectangular shape is called cell. In this cell is represented as A, 1. So this will represent as B, 1. And if you could, this cell will be represented as C, and see what is this 14. So see 14. So this is how actually we make the representation of each cells. So this will be that. So it is very easy to work with Google the sheets. So don't worry, I'll teach you each and everything so that you will have a very clear idea how to work with it. So first and foremost thing, let's first have a serial number let me first increase the font size so that we can work comfortably in this. What I'm going to do is serial number. Well, I'm typing here my name THASIN. So let me explain you what is that called, the lower part of this, actually this formatting toolbar, so that as we all know, once you select this, you can make this as bold. So let me select THASIN and I can make this bold, I can make this italic, or else if you want a stripe you can make it, or else if you want text color in it so that you can have your text color change. And at the same time, you want it to be full color actually in that whole, so you can have. And for example, if you want to have a border, so you can click this borders and you can have borders here. So this is called borders. And so
friends, today we are done with our today's class. So all you want to do is just continue this class 2 and till the end so that you can have a clear understanding.